Some argue a female leader may be what the party needs to beat Wynne, but Mulroney and Elliott could end up splitting the moderate vote, which would help Ford race up the middle. Christine Elliott joins me now in her first TV interview. Thank you for coming here.
Pleasure. Thank you.
Yeah, rock and roll. Oh, my goodness, this past week.
It's been very intense for everybody within the party, I think.
So it wasn't that long ago that Patrick Brown won. You were up against him. You lost. Now we're learning that almost a third of the memberships of the party that were sold during his time are fraudulent. Did he win unfairly?
No, I think there was a process in place for the candidates, everybody that was in the race. It just ended up being the two of us at the end.
But it looks like there was a lot of cheating.
I really can't comment on that. As far as I know, it was a fair process. I just certainly didn't make any complaints about it. After Patrick won, he won quite significantly. And as far as I was concerned, that was the end of it.
Hmm. So you didn't have questions at the time?
I was disappointed, of course. But it seemed to me that the majority of the party had spoken and that they chosen Patrick as their leader.
Were you ever approached by anyone trying to get, saying, hey, I can boost your memberships? Because obviously we're learning now that something was going on.
No, I wasn't. I mean, to me, it's a fair process is really important, that you only sign up people who want to be members. And I'm assuming that's how the process went for everybody.
But it didn't.
But there's questions now, obviously. But I think for me, it's a brand new day. I know that Doug is running. I think that there will be other people that are going to be in the contest. And what I'm looking for is a level playing field for everybody.
So are those people who were with Patrick Brown during his leadership race and afterwards, and we're now learning that there's rot in the party, should those people be thrown out of the party?
No, I don't think so. I think what's happening now is that the party is pulling together. People are dispersing to different camps. There are people who are working on my campaign who worked with Patrick last time. And so I think that everybody is really sincere in their desire to work together, to pull the party together, and to make sure that we're ready to win an election in the next couple of months. There's not very much time, and we need to keep our eye on the prize, which is defeating the Liberals and becoming the government next time.
The other big story in your party, of course, is the accusation of sexual misconduct against Patrick Brown and against Rick Dykstra, the party president. The former prime minister, Stephen Harper, because Dykstra was an MP, and Andrew Scheer have been drawn into this. Should they have been more transparent about what was going on? These allegations go back to when he was a federal MP.
Well, I think that maybe it's the lawyer in me, but everybody deserves to have their opportunity to clear their name. And so both with Patrick and Rick, they have the opportunity to tell their side of the story. And we haven't heard that yet. So I think in all fairness, they deserve that opportunity before public completely turns against them. It's their right to have their day in court.
Our Queen's Park reporter says that when the rumors were circulating around this at the time that he approached your camp, did you ever, like you must have heard at the time, did you try and look into it? I'm just wondering if you too were like, I'm not touching this.
You know, in a political campaign, you hear all kinds of rumors, but mostly that's what it is. It's rumors. And so did I know anything specific? No, I did not. But there were things that other people were saying, but it's something that now has been brought forward to the light. But both Patrick and Rick deserve the opportunity to say what they want to say.
Well, it's a very different world now. These accusations are treated so differently.
It is. It's a totally different atmosphere now with the campaigns that are going on right now. But I think that, to me, in fairness, when allegations are raised, there's two parties to this, and the other party gets to have their opportunity to get their view of what happened.
I'm curious, there's lots of famous families in politics all of a sudden, it seems. You know, you've got the Trudeaus, obviously. You've got, now it seems, Caroline Mulroney's going to be running for the leadership as well. You've got Rob Ford, Doug Ford in the race. Are we becoming a country where you need to have a pedigree to be premier or be prime minister?
Well, I hope not, because I don't have one. I think that it's really important for people to look at the experience and the knowledge of the people who are running for leadership, because it's very important. The person who gets selected as the leader of the PC party may well be our next premier. So I think that that's what people should really look at, and that's why I've come forward as a candidate, because I do have 9 years of experience as an MPP. I've also done a lot of work as a volunteer in my community. And I truly believe that I'm the one that can lead the party and beat Kathleen Wynne.
We'll be watching. Should be quite the race. Thanks so much.
Thank you. Pleasure. Thank you.
Christine Elliott.